Natsy, Natsy, come here. Cell Squad is something. Don't look after dance, man. Yo, you want something? Yeah, man, Cell Squad is... Yeah, but don't lock it up. Don't tell her. Guess what, Squad? Go buy a peanut from the peanut, man. When him a go through in a the dance, aye. In a inbox, him have everything you want. Herbs by the bud and by the stock. I like. The top shell and him a shell down the bar. Watch it, man, you step on them clock.
Welcome to True Island History Channel. This is the Port Royal history and the history of Jamaica as well, surrounding Port Royal back in the day. Now, it soon became apparent that Port Royal was a perfect place for pirates and its privateers. It had a large deep water natural harbor for protecting ships and anchor, and it was close to Spanish shipping lanes and ports. And once it started to gain fame as a pirate haven, the town quickly changed. It began filling up brothels and taverns and drinkings and illicit sex and drunk and all kind of fights and sharing and robbing and pilfering and everything and godly start cropping up in that. Oh, God, it was a hell, but it was place for men of greed and hunger and brave men and warfare and everything that was ungodly was there. And that's what they fed off of. That's what they loved. That was it. That was their thing back in the day. So who am I to chastise them? If you were in that time, you had to do what, well, I wouldn't say what the Romans do. I'd say what the pirates did, huh? Yeah, so the brothels quickly filled up the drinking halls. Pass me my drink or meat and wine. Hurry up, leave me. Me do my thing. Gold, you said? On Pirate's Island? Wow. Oh, gather some men. Paddle the oars. Unhanker the ships. We go there at sea's end, at dawn's break, at sunrise, and fill our tanks to the... and all kinds of... You know, yeah. So, Port Royal became the busiest port in the Americas, primarily run and operated by pirates and buccaneers. The booming business done by pirates and privateers in the Caribbean soon led to other industries. Port Royal soon became a trading center for enslaved people. Sugar and raw materials such as wood. Smuggling boomed as Spanish ports in the New World were officially closed to foreigners, but represented a huge market for enslaved African people and goods manufactured in Europe. Because it was a rough and tumble outpost, Port Royal had a little loose attitude towards religion, and soon was home to Anglicans, Jews, Quakers, Puritans, Presbyterians, and Catholics. By 1690, Port Royal was a huge and important town as Boston, and many of the local merchants became quite healthy and wealthy. It all came crashing down, though, on June 1692. And that day, a massive earthquake shook Port Royal, dumping most of it into the harbor. An estimated 5,000 people died in the quake or shortly after that of injuries or disease. The city was ruined. Looting was rampant. And for a time, all order broke down. Many thought that the city had been singled out for punishment by God for its wickedness as Sodom and Gomorrah too reborn. An effort was made to rebuild the city, but it was devastated once again in 1703 by fire. It was repeatedly hit by hurricanes and even more earthquakes in the following years, and by 1774, it was essentially a quiet village. Today, Port Royal is a small Jamaican coastal village. It retains very little of its former glory. Some old buildings are still intact, the Giddy House and, you know, a tourist attraction for school trips and, you know, several other. It's worth a trip for history buffs. It's valuable archaeological site, however, and digs into all our continue to turn up interesting items with increased interest in the age of piracy. Port Royal is poised to undergo a renaissance of sorts with theme parks, museums, and other attractions being built and planned. Port Royal glory days as the greatest of pirate ports were brief but noteworthy. Many famous pirates and privateers of the days passed through Port Royal. Here are some of the more memorable moments of Port Royal as a pirate haven. in 1668, legendary privateer Captain Henry Morgan departed for his famous attack on the city of Portobello from Port Royal. In 1671, Morgan made his greatest and final raid, the sacking of the city of Panama, launched from where? Port Royal. On August 25th, 1688, Captain Morgan died in Port Royal and was given a send-off of worthy of the greatest of privateers. Warships in port fired their guns. He lay in state at the King's House, and his body was carried off through town and gun carriage to its final resting place. In December of 1718, Private John Calico Jack Rackham captured the merchant ship Kingston within sight of Port Royal, infuriating local merchants who sent bounty hunters after him. On November 18, 1720, Rackham and four other pirates who had been captured were hanged at the gallows points at Port Royal. Two of his schoolmates, Anne Bonny and Mary Read, were spared because they were both pregnant. On March 29, 1721, infamous pirate Charles Vane was hanged at the gallows point in Port Royal. And if you want to find out more about Port Royal, there's a series on Stars called Black Sails. I've watched that series about three times. Very interesting. Tells you about Blackbeard, Charles Vane, Captain John Rackham, in depth, and Bonny. Yes. Very interesting. Lead right back to Port Royal. So you can check that series out. And we're going to leave it here, but Port Royal, man, very historical site. And it's a quiet city now, you know. I've taken several drives, several visits over there, because, you know, I'm a Jamaican. I grew up there. And the buildings over there still maintains that archaeological, that old look, you know. And there are mixed people over there. You can see them mixed with white, and probably Tainos coming up, and blacks mixed with white. That heritage is still there. It's nice to go over there and chill and make some good dishes over there, man. Nice fresh fish. And once you go over there, you just smell the sea, you know, the salt water, the breeze. And it's just that ambiance, and like you can feel the spirit of olden days just permeate the air. And I mean, it's Port Royal, and who knows? It's always the same, history repeats itself, but maybe there'll be another earthquake because of where Port Royal is located. Maybe it sits on a tectonic plate. Who knows? There'll be a huge shift and boom, earthquake, more damage. But I mean, it's calm in terms of violence, so maybe we'll be spared the wrath or by the gods. But for now, it was fun bringing you this exciting topic. And again, I hope you found it interesting. Until our next topic, thanks for stopping by with us. And please like and leave a comment if you will, and share the content. I implore you. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Thanks for stopping by. And please follow our Instagram channel and our Patreon page. We're just setting it up, so we'll have exclusive content in there. And do remember our main page, True Island Stories channel, where we have over 700 or 600 videos over there of raw, unadulterated contents. And we have several books out. You can check that out, Darker Side of Paradise, Smudfest, and online now. So you have a wonderful day, and God bless until our next story drops. Blessed. Peace out.
Blatsy, come here. Cell Squad is something. Don't look after dance, man. Yo, you want something? Yeah, man, Cell Squad is... yeah, but don't lock it down. Don't tell her. Guess what, Squad? Go buy a peanut from the peanut man. When him a go through in a the dance, aye. In a inbox, him have everything you want. Herbs by the bud and by the stock, I like. The top shield, I did my shield down the bar. Watch it, man, you step on them clock.